Hey guys, it's July here. Today I'm going to be telling you how to color in Blender. Alright guys, so I just opened up one of my projects and as you can see, everything is grey. Now, this is a bit odd because as you can see in the side here, materials actually have a colored material. Why is it grey, you may ask? Well, we are actually in solid view instead of rendered view. To switch to rendered view, you need to press Z and then you need to click rendered. Well, that looks a lot better, but as you can see, the colors are still washed out. I actually have a tutorial on how to fix this. I'll leave a link in the top right corner of this video. Alright guys, so you might be wondering how I achieved all these complex gradients and these normal emission shaders, okay? So basically guys, in Blender, on the right here you have lots of tabs. Each of them has its own purpose. For the purpose of this video, we're only using material properties. So left click on that. And it will actually open up this dialog over here. Okay, so this is basically your material menu. Alright guys, so you might see it like this, which means that you don't actually have a material. So you need to select new, and then you'll have a default material that is put here. But guys, I actually don't like to use principled BSDF, because then you need to have a light source. You might need a light source for your animation, but for mine, I prefer to use emission shaders. So I'm going to change the surface type from principled BSDF to emission. And as you can see, now it is extremely bright. But guys, I don't really want the background to be white, because I think that it blends in too much with my text and my other colors up here. So what I'm actually going to do, guys, is navigate to the right here, select color, and change it from white, and then change it to black. So guys, this is basically the area where you can select all your colors. And then you have a strength value here. This basically determines the strength of the emission, but we're not going to use that today because for my motion graphics, I always leave it at 1. Alright guys, so now I'm going to give you guys a quick overview of how I did these cool gradients. So the first step to actually doing cool gradients like this is to navigate to the shading tab up here. Okay guys, now that we're in the shading tab, you'll actually see that this has gone grey again. So once again, to fix that, we're just going to press Z and then press rendered. But we have to make sure that our cursor is actually in the 3D viewport, because if it's in here and we press Z, it won't do anything. As you can see, this is my node structure. This is how I've made the gradients for my thumbnail. So basically what I have here is the texture coordinate, which is connected to a mapping node, which is connected to a gradient texture with linear, which is connected to a color ramp, which is connected to an emission shader, which then is connected to the surface of my object. Basically, what texture coordinate does is it gives a vector coordinate for your gradient to be based around. So in this case, the gradient is actually based around this little box here, so the window. That is then connected to a mapping node, and this mapping node allows us to change that vector. So we could move it along the x-axis so that it is located in a different location. But I actually like it where it is by default because that makes it centered to the screen. We then have a gradient texture. This is pretty self-explanatory. It's basically just a texture type and has a few options here, each of which do their own thing. So we could do spherical and then it would come out from a point. It's pretty cool. Next we have a color ramp and we're basically just telling Blender what colors do we want to be in our gradient. And yeah, I have this very, very colorful gradient to capture people's attention in the thumbnail. Alright guys, and then we have it connected to an emission node. So this is basically our surface type that we were talking about before. And then we have our emission connected to the surface, which is basically just the surface of our object. Alright guys, one last thing in the video. Over here we actually have a material list. So if you click this button here, it will give you a list of all your materials. And you can actually click one and it will switch the material for your selected object to that. I also just want to make one more side note guys. Make sure that when you are changing the material of an object, you have it selected, because if you don't have your object selected, then it won't work. Alright everyone, thank you for watching the video, I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to leave any suggestions in the comments below and I'll be sure to make videos about them. But other than that, I'll see you next time, remember to subscribe and like the video. Bye.